Hello from the inaugural WellStat Conference in Scottsdale, Arizona. I'm Julie Parisi, joined now by Nicole Boyson of Northeastern University. Nicole, thanks so much for being here.
You're welcome. It's a pleasure.
Tell me what some of the most engaging topics you find with your students at Northeastern.
Yeah, so I talk to my students about a lot of different things. So we focus on, I teach classes on investments, corporate finance, fixed income, alternative investments, but I think the most fun things to talk about are kind of what's going on currently. So with respect to like fixed income, we're talking about negative interest rates. With respect to investments, we're starting to talk a little bit about some of my own research, which is looking at sort of changes in the industry. So, and then everything else, it's sort of just trying to meet their needs. So I have freshmen and I have like people older than me in my MBA classes. So it's trying to figure out sort of where to meet them and what they need to learn the most, and trying to always keep that fresh and change it up.
And what areas do you find might need more focus, more study?
Yeah, I think a lot of areas, like just basic personal finance. And so even though I'm a finance professor, I don't think my students know as much as they should. And so when I teach investments or intro, I always make a point to say, hey, let's talk about things like budgeting and retirement planning and debt. And I think they're grateful for that because, again, it's not something that comes with the curriculum.
Sure.
Yeah.
Now to a question that we cannot get away from, the future of the fiduciary rule.
Yeah.
What are your thoughts?
Yeah, so the fiduciary rule is sort of dead, right? So now we have Regulation BI, and Regulation BI, as you heard Barbara and I complaining about in the panel we just did, it's not sufficient. It does raise some brokers to a higher standard, but it's not doing much in the fiduciary space. In fact, I would argue it's reducing or making the fiduciary standard weaker. And the problem, of course, is that the rule is based on disclosure and trying to regulate your way around, which is really what should be a really simple basic rule of life, which is treat your clients well. Don't put your own interest in front of theirs. I said that right. Don't put your own interest in front of theirs, and you know, try to avoid those conflicts. What the SEC says is it's kind of okay if you have conflicts, just disclose them. And we know disclosure doesn't work. And so the really big problem is that there are a lot of advisors out there who aren't really thinking about the fiduciary rule in terms of conflicts. They're thinking about it in terms of, well, am I a fiduciary? And if so, how am I going to get paid? Rather than thinking really hard about sort of what they should be doing with respect to their clients. And I should note that it's at the firm level. So there are lots of individual advisors who are trying to do well by their clients, but unfortunately they work for firms that have these really endemic, really large conflicts, and they serve the majority of clients.
Nicole, we'll leave it there. Thanks so much for your time.
Thank you very much.